like it's God is this. About it's God, it says a circular arc revolves, this arc revolved about God. A circular arc revolves about its chord. Let me take this in the chord here. A, B, let me take center is C. Okay, and this chord, this arc AB is revolved about this chord AB. Arc AB, if I take here D, let me take this X axis, this is O, Y and Y dash axis here. Okay, so this circular arc is revolved about this chord. Now what does it say? I would say that chord is subtending angle at the center is twice alpha. That means alpha here and alpha here. These two angles are alpha alpha. Okay, so if I take any point P here on this arc, okay, this arc here, let me take P point here, and this is P and this is Q point. If I take P point here, and if I draw perpendicular from P to, because this is revolved about the initial line. What is it about? About the, now when 2 alpha is angle, subtended by the arc at the center. A circular arc revolved about its chord, okay, about its chord here. Okay, so if it is chord, then we have to find out this length here. Because this is revolved about this length here. This is Q now, sorry. And this is P here. So this length is what? Because this length is the radius, but will work as radius. We have to find out this length here. If I draw perpendicular from that point to the arc here, I mean, sorry, to the X here. So what is this length, total length is? And now here, okay. Here it is A, radius of the circle, okay, and this length, we have to find out this is what length. Now if I take theta, is the angle here, P, coordinates of P, let me take A cos theta, and this is A sin theta, okay. So this is the coordinates here. So if I take A cos theta is total length from this point to this, this is here. This is A, because this length is A here, radius of the circle, and therefore, or R cos theta we can take, this is R cos theta, and this is R here, length of P, this is theta angle, and this whole is alpha. Okay, so what about this length? This is AC, AC and this OC, OC and this, let me take here. Any point PQR, R let me take. So PR, if we have to calculate this length OP, but radius we have to find out, so this length is what that we have to calculate. So before that, if I take here PN, this is M here, so PN is equal to CR. Okay, but this whole length is A, if I take this R radius or OP into this value, angle of this is cos theta. This is base here. This is A cos theta. So this length is A. So this is A cos theta here. So A cos theta is total length, and this is A cos alpha. But at this point, if I take, then this is OC equal to here. OC upon OA equal to cos alpha here. Therefore, OC we have to find out. OC equal to OA cos alpha. Now O is A, radius of the circle, it is A cos alpha, try to understand. And what is this length, PN is equal to CR, PN equal to CR, PN equal to CR, and the CR is equal to OR minus OC, CR is equal to OR minus OC, OC we have already calculated, OC is A cos alpha. Okay, so OR is this. This is A cos alpha. It is A cos theta, A cos theta minus A cos alpha. It means this is nothing but A common. This is cos theta minus cos alpha. This is the this length. Pn is a cos theta. This total length a cos theta. A is radius. A cos theta is this length x coordinate of OR. OR length is a cos theta, and this OC is from this AX cos alpha. This alpha angle is there. This is base. This is perpendicular. This is a cos a sin alpha is this length AC, and OC is a cos alpha. We have calculated here. Therefore, PN, let me write here solution. Here solution is, what is AP? What we find here? So here PN is equal to PN, the perpendicular length. Perpendicular length of the perpendicular length from P to the chord AB. Chord AB. Okay, so perpendicular length to chord AB that we have calculated. So this perpendicular length is this CR here, which is equal to, so PN here was equal to, that I have written down there, PN equal to CR here, in this case CR, but CR equal to OR minus OC. Now OR is A cos theta minus OC is A cos alpha. This is alpha angle. A cos alpha. A can be taken common. This is cos theta minus cos alpha. So this length PN we have calculated. Now what is the, therefore, area? Area is now twice pi into PN into ds. This is ds here. Delta s of ds. PQ is delta s. Then, and limits we can take, what are the limits here? From this to this whole arc. So here we have to take alpha 2 minus alpha 2 plus alpha, because theta is from minus alpha to plus alpha here. Their length can be taken. Okay, or 0 to alpha if I take, then twice we have to make, because this whole arc is 2p and the limit is from minus alpha to plus alpha. Theta equal to minus alpha to plus alpha. Let me now take, therefore, area, required area of the surface generated by area of the surface generated is equal to, this is limits minus alpha to plus alpha, theta equal to minus alpha below. Plus alpha, this is 2 pi into Pn into ds. Now ds upon d theta, that also we have to find out. Minus alpha to plus alpha, limit is twice pi. This is minus alpha to plus alpha, or we can write here twice into 0 to alpha, no problem. 0 to alpha here, and Pn is, we have taken a into Pn is A into cos theta minus cos alpha into ds. This is ds upon d theta into, okay, this is ds into d theta here. So ds upon d theta, we have to find out again in the same way, dx upon d theta whole square, but dy upon d theta whole square square root, that we have to calculate. So therefore ds upon d theta will be, let me now write it here. Now here ds upon d theta is equal to under root dx upon d theta whole square plus dy upon d theta whole square. Now dx upon d theta, these are the value, x is this, y is this. So that will be dx upon d theta will be minus a sine theta whole square. Plus this is a cos theta whole square. That means a square will come out, so a will come out as, this is sine square theta plus cos square theta, that means a only. So ds ds only theta is a only. Okay, so that let me write here. Therefore, required area. Therefore, the required area is equal to 4 pi, limits now 0 to alpha, let me write. And this is a into that a also come out, this is 4 pi a square into cos theta minus cos alpha into d, sorry, minus 1 is, okay, only cos theta minus cos alpha into d theta. So we can integrate that, 4 pi a square, integration of this will be cos theta is sin theta, minus cos alpha is there, so this is constant, into theta, limits now 0 to alpha, we can write here, this is 4 pi a square, sin theta means theta in place of theta is sin alpha here, minus alpha into, sorry, alpha into, this is alpha, into cos alpha. Alpha into cos alpha, this is the answer here. Okay, so this value is, the answer is not given, but we have to just calculate it. So this is 4 into pi a square, within bracket it is sine alpha, we got minus alpha, theta is alpha here, so alpha into cos alpha, this is the answer here. Area is this much square. Okay guys, so this is area required is 4 pi a square into sin alpha minus alpha into cos alpha. Try to understand. This is the answer here. This is question number 9 we have done. Only one question is left over. That has two parts. I'll take, okay, after 5 minutes time. So now, no space is there. No space. Yes. Okay, see you then after 5 minutes.